Hey guys, welcome back to Crafting with Cardboard.
I'm Mr. Waxman, and I'm going to be showing you how to make some fun, easy crafts while we're all staying home. So far, we've made some buildings, people, trees, cars, and houses. I hope you guys have been keeping up with the videos, and also maybe coming up with some own stuff to do with your cardboard, some of your own stuff to do. Just like I have added some little details here, as you can see, some little stuff in the sky, and some backgrounds. One friend sent me a picture of a convertible that she made out of cardboard all on her own, which is pretty cool, so you can check that out. Remember to be sending me pictures of any kind of artwork that you guys are doing at home so that we can continue to enjoy each other's work just like we do in class. Also remember that it is absolutely and totally okay to ask adults for help, especially if you're using a tricky tool or having a tough time with something, but you should always try something on your own first because that's the best way to learn. Okay? Today it is really beautiful out, so we're gonna take a break from the cardboard and head outside for some nature crafting. Come on!
Now, I don't know about you guys, but I've been starting to feel a little cooped up at home. And I'm happy to stay home because I know that when we do, we're keeping ourselves and other people safe. But it can get a little bit boring staying inside all day. So if you have a yard or a park or some hiking trails near you that are still open, that you're allowed to go to, going there with an adult can be a great way to lift your spirits and change your mood. So I'm going to show you how to make something cool and creative while you're outside in the woods. One of my favorite things to do, fairy houses. Fairy houses are exactly what they sound like. Little homes made in the woods for fairies or maybe some little outdoor critters made only from the things you can find in the woods or in nature, like pine cones, sticks, twigs, bark, whatever is around, okay? There are a bunch around here that other people have made and left in this little fairy village, so let's take a look at a couple. All right, this one's pretty cool, pretty simple. Just kind of a little bit of a pile. Maybe it used to be something a little more, but these are all mostly things you can find, even in the park, parks around Dorchester and Roxbury or wherever else in Boston you are. So that's a very doable one. Obviously there are some bigger ones like this. Somebody found some nice big sticks and they made what looks kind of like a little bit of a teepee, which is like kind of like a tent that some Native Americans live in or used to live in. And here's some shells that they found. I don't know where they got these, but that looks pretty cool. Got a little bark walkway, how creative. Let's take a look at a couple more. Got a nice big boy here for some big fairies, I suppose. I like this one. You see what this person did is they made some curtains for the front door out of these pine needles. Isn't that so pretty? I think that one's really cool. I would definitely live in there if I were a fairy. And let's take a look at two more. This person did an excellent job. They got these big sticks from at the top. They look kind of like, I don't know, antennas or something. They cover the whole thing in nice, beautiful green pine. It looks so fresh and inviting. Oh, with some moss on the inside, like for a cozy little fairy bed. This person really wants a fairy to move in here. And they even got a little, maybe that's like a mailbox or something for fairies, I don't know. All right. Oh yeah, check out this, let's check out this one. Ooh, some more shells and bark. That is pretty dang cool. All right, now, I like to work a little bit smaller, so I'm gonna start by gathering some smaller things, like some leaves and twigs and pine cones and whatever else. So, let's get started. Right, now that I've got some stuff to make my house, I'm gonna begin. I'm gonna show you how I like to make a fairy house, but I do it differently almost every time, and you guys are totally free to make it literally however you want. There's no rule or right or wrong way to do this. I'm just gonna show you how I like to make it. So I'm gonna start by taking some of my bigger sticks, and I'm gonna use these to make some beams for my house. So a stick, and when I say beams, I mean like the sticks that hold everything up. So I'm gonna do four, so I can have four walls. Let's stick these into the ground. And make sure when you guys are looking for stuff that you aren't ripping anything off of a live plant, that you are only taking stuff that is already dead and on the ground, because we don't want to hurt the nature that we are trying to enjoy. All right, I got my four beams. Now I'm gonna use some bark for the sides. Lovely. And then I'm gonna make a doorway. Now I'm gonna lay some sticks over the top for a little roof. Maybe some more sticks going the other way. Okay, now I'm gonna add some pine needles for the roof. There's like a thatched roof like they used to make. All right, now for the finishing touch, I'm gonna put two little pine cone boys in front, and they can be like little guards, but instead of people keeping people out, they're gonna be welcoming the fairies in to their new home. And maybe a nice leaf walkway. I'll make it look like little rocks, but it's actually just leaves. I'm gonna rip them up. Isn't that pretty? Okay. Well, that was fun. Now, before we go and visit Sam in the workshop, I wanted to take a second to mention that even though it's great to get outside and get a little creative, you should only do that if you can do it safely. And what I mean by that is making sure you're staying with your grown-up and avoiding other people. So if your local park is a little bit too crowded one day, just come back another day and do it then. All right? Now, let's go see what Sam's up to. Hey Sam.
Hey David.
How's it going?
It's going good.
What are you working on today?
So this is part of a bigger project I'm working on. So I'm making this big foldable screen that I'm going to use as a backdrop for my photos.
Oh, cool.
So I started by making a frame out of wood.
Mm-hmm.
And now I am sewing together backdrops that are going to Velcro onto the frame.
Oh,
so
okay.
I'll show you what one of the finished ones looks like right here.
Ooh.
Yeah.
So this is the Velcro that you sewed onto the sides?
Yep. So there will be Velcro on the side of the frame, and then you can stick this right onto it.
Oh, cool. And you can use, I assume, lots of different kinds of fabrics to make different kinds of sets for your photos?
Exactly. So I'm using a few different kinds of fabrics and making a few different versions of these screens to put onto the backdrop.
That's rad. And did you know how to sew before you started this project?
I didn't actually know how to sew. It was an idea that I had that I knew that I would need to sew for. So I learned this week how to do it. And yeah, I don't know. It's as part of being an artist is having a project idea and having to learn new skills to, you know, bring that idea, you know, all the way through to how you want it.
Yeah, totally. Well, that's really cool. I love that you're willing to learn new skills and stuff to make your ideas come to life.
Yeah.
Well, thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, so just like Sam told us, works of art often require several different steps, and sometimes even learning a new skill to be able to make something. As artists, we should always be willing to learn something new and to learn from our mistakes when we're trying to make something new or come up with a new idea. So, let's move on to our next project. Okay, now, I've talked a lot about how there are plenty of projects to do at home using non-traditional art materials, but I realize I haven't actually shown you any, so we're going to do one now. We're going to make something called a found object color wheel, and here's an example of one made by a student from a different school. Basically, what you do is you make a rainbow circle using objects that you find around your house. I'm going to start by looking for things that are the primary colors, red, blue, and yellow. Colors. Now remember, we can use those colors to make the secondary colors, orange, purple, and green. So I'm going to find those next. Objects. Now it is time to assemble my color wheel. Like I said, a color wheel is just like a big circle that's a rainbow, and you use your primary and secondary colors. But as you guys may have noticed, I also got some tertiary colors, which are even in between the primary and secondary, and those are colors like turquoise, violet, aquamarine, and maybe some like orangey yellows. And so the idea with the color wheel is to make sure that the colors are transitioning smoothly from one to the next, creating what's called a gradient, which is that same exact word I just used, when colors are transitioning from one to the other really smoothly, all right? So now I'm gonna start to arrange, and I think I'm gonna start with red. Time making it, and that I thought a lot about color while I was making it. So that word I used earlier, gradient, meaning one color transitioning smoothly from one to the next, I tried to make sure that I was doing that inside my color wheel too. So if you look at the green, for instance, you'll notice that closer to the yellow, I've picked lighter greens that have a little bit of yellow in them. And closer to the blue area, I have some darker greens or turquoises that have a little bit of blue in them. And I tried to keep that going all the way around the color wheel. You can arrange yours in any shape you want. One thing to make sure you do, please, please, please send me pictures of yours so I can see the awesome work that you're doing at home and so I can see all the cool things that you found to add to your color wheel. I will leave a link or an email in the description of the video so that you guys have an easier way to do that. And other than that, I think we're all good with this project. Okay. Okay, thanks for stopping by for another episode of Crafting with Cardboard. I hope you guys had fun making crafts inside and outside, and I hope you guys keep finding creative ways to do stuff at home. See you next time.